I said, that last little bit of feed. One coming into the studio. So, y'all ready? All right. Hey, how y'all doing? I want to say, it's good to be back, at least partially. We're not quite done. We're like 9/10 of the way done. So. Been incredible dealing with the Lord's Shelter, the 7-1 program, after working with Ground Squad, and Ground Squad went to the street music, so we did street music for almost a year and a half or so, and it was incredible, touchdown with people in the streets. It's a little bit different, you know. I grew up multi-million dollar experience, $1 million mansions, things like that. So, luxury cars, luxury vehicles, chrome, performance rims, stuff like that, thing like that. So, it's a little bit different being out in the streets amongst the people and rolling on metro buses, things like that. However, security's tight. I feel safe for the most part. I have a couple close calls, and however, nonetheless, you know, we got military personnel, local authorities, and we got the people. So it's definitely an experience getting the street music and the Infinite Eternal project done. Everything that have happened within the last 4 or 5 years culminating into the Infinite Eternal project. So the Ground Squad, after terrorist attacks, from U.S. reporting agency, street music for Universal Spirit, Undisputed U.S. Records, all that, everything went into a culminating experience that lead into the Infinite Eternal project. So, okay, we gotta get this done. I got a few more minutes before I'm supposed to be somewhere already. No, it's not a hoax, not a game. It's the real me. People have seen me, and I had no idea. We walk around with millions and billions of dollars in regular label capital, and the music rotating around the world, 150 to million to a quarter of a billion dollar in value, and we've been distributing currency the whole entire while. So it's been real, real experience. Meeting people in the streets is a blessing. Having touchdown with people in the streets, a little bit different from my normal experience. I usually manage my days much differently. However, I got a lot of agents working. Like I said, a lot of security that keep it together. Next. Okay. No, I haven't really been able to build my family as much as I would have liked, because the streets, just like going to the military, almost. It's a different current. I had to actually come down in degrees to the streets. Okay, it's like air pressure. The higher in degrees, the higher the pressure. Okay, so like it's just like being a space station. You have to have a pressurized chamber and a spacesuit in order to survive correctly. Same thing with wealth. When you're wealthy, you way up here. Okay, and people on the streets, they calm down in the first degrees. Okay, and so they had to actually lower us in degrees, lower us in altitude, spiritually, physically, and mentally. So it's not the same me when I'm in the streets as it is when I'm rolling, you know, luxury vehicle, 26 chrome rims, bass knocking in the back, coming from a multi-million-dollar mansion and things like that. I have been able to see my mom. My mom very flexible, so that's a blessing. However, for all my ladies and the God children, these and that, I've been kind of far removed. So I'm really ready to get back to the family, back to my normal experience. Even though being a street been good, that makes sense. Okay. I mean, you know, it's incredible. It doesn't really feel much different. You know, they say people making history generally don't realize that, because every day kind of like a struggle. Being in the street is very challenging, if way more challenging than being on stage in front of millions of people. Okay. However, I've been able to balance, and I have many people working who have put sacrifice to ensure that we get the street music done. And they assured me we're gonna finish the Infinite Eternal project. Okay. I'll make sure we get a name. Am I getting a name right? Hold on, y'all. Yeah, the Infinite Eternal project. Yeah. Well, I'm excited. It's the first I've been exposed to many things. I've been inspired by many people. Tupac Shakur and the Pac family. I'm friends with Niecy Knight, and I had done a song. Niecy Knight, Suge Knight, Niece had done a song together that I look to see in the future. So I also sent something to Music World for Beyonce. So I think they might have an involved there. So also the Temptations. I got a song done with one of the Outlaw family members. And not the Tupac Outlaw, Outlaw family. Omega Outlaw. And Dollar P recorded Dollar P, one of the Temptation. Dave Ruffin Son, Dollar P. And I got a few other songs with some major artists. So I already got some $1 million single that have unreleased. So no matter what happened, we successful. No matter what happened, we've been on the underground long enough. And even though we have gone mainstream around the world, I have multi-millions of dollars of music rotating the world, more than 150, 250 million, a quarter of $1 billion of music. It's phenomenal what we're doing. We are setting records. People haven't seen any formidable marketing. We have just been using online social media and things like that. So we have been submitted to the Guinness Book of World Records. Hey, Simone Biles, I see. We have been submitted to the Guinness Book of World Records for having most songs on one album, with more than 500 songs, up to 550 songs on one album, which is phenomenal for one album. So how do I feel about it? Well, it's not really work to me, okay? Recording artist material, not work. And when I record, I love what I do. So every song, I get into it. It's a loving experience. Enjoyable experience. So I'm excited. Look, I got to run a couple minutes. So, I'm out here in the streets. And some of y'all have seen me in the streets on pause. I would appreciate y'all not bothering me. I had a couple close calls. Security and the police, had to make a couple arrests over the last 4 or 5 years. However, we got the Lord Shelter 7-1 program nearly finalized, so they're putting people in the house. The whole idea is creating enough buzz around the world to actually sweep Skid Row and clean everybody off of Skid Row downtown and Santa Monica and all the streets all the way to the Inland Empire to see the clean homeless people off the streets. So we have billionaires, okay, and I have been inspired by other artists, Tupac Shakur, and it's a long list. I don't want to get into like all the people who, Paris Hilton has been real, real inspirational. I really appreciate you, Paris, for being you, baby, Cash Money Records. Y'all been a blessing. Diddy, I seen Master P rolling up Crenshaw. Well, I think Symphonique. I think that was White Phantom or something like that. So that was real nice to see the blessings. I also touched down with a few other people. However, it's really not about me. It's about the people and giving back to the people. So after being called a trillion, Rihanna 50, diamonds. I came out with diamond plaque. Rihanna came out with diamonds. I came out with 777. International separation. Rihanna went on 777 tour. You know, we have a spiritual connection that I have since it accept it. So, you know, it's something whether you like it or not, you know, you have to accept. So, a big shout out to Rihanna, Shakira, and all the blessings from the Hispanic families all around the world for keeping things working in the Spanish world. Because we have Spanish families also. Spanish, black, a Russian. Big shout out to my Russian family. Victoria Viktorovna, I hired her, or I had interest in hiring her to play the piano. A Russian piano is all we need, okay? And she very good from 7 years old, 8, 9, however old she is now. So I look forward to seeing her in the future. You see God in my heart. I'm a creator responsible for manifesting all things. So if you see that, then you see that. You know, you're seeing other people, you're seeing your own experience. So I appreciate that. Thank you. No, I'm not wearing too many jewels in the streets. I didn't have any jewels after a while, just recently, just within the past couple of days, because we finally got a break. That thing almost over. I just, you know, threw on simple jewelry, earring, I'll wear a chain, I'll probably watch, you know, not too much. They won't let me see $10,000 in jewels on the streets. So I'm probably just about right there at 10 grand. So I can't really do much more than this. Yeah, I've been eating healthy. I've been eating fruits and vegetables. In the street, you know, if I eat too much more, the fruits and vegetables, peanuts, you know, it induces vomiting. So, you know, being down at such a low degree, very, very challenging. You have to stay clean and pure. It's been rough. I have some more challenging moments, but very clean now. A nice clean outfit. And I'm getting back into me from these streets. Look, I got to run. I really appreciate y'all. I know y'all got a lot of questions. However, I got to go for now. And you can. All right. I got to run. I love y'all. All my beautiful fans, all my lovely ladies. I've been celibate the last 3 years, so I look forward to it.